and families that have supported this program and these kids throughout the years. Truly, you are the people who have been so helpful. So please give yourselves a round of applause for doing everything you've done for these young people. Awesome. So I want to embarrass a few seniors before they get to sing their last piece for you. So I'm going to call each one up, but I would love to share a few words. I want to start with Miss AJ Omar. Could you please give Miss AJ Omar? AJ is my go-to leader in choir and mad jazz this year. And not only is she very attentive and musically talented, she leads with kindness and humility. AJ took on a leadership role this year as an alto section leader, and even though she's used to singing soprano, she made that switch very, very gracefully. She developed a very beautiful organ. So I'm getting to know her during our road trip to Dorian Vocal Festival at Luther College and hearing more about what the future holds for her. She was very patient as I made her and maybe listen to the entire Hamilton album. On that same trip, we got stuck in a really nasty ice storm, and AJ again was very grateful because it was her birthday that last trip and stuff. So we got to hang out in a coffee shop and celebrate her birthday. Just another example of her patience and her kindness. But mostly, I am most impressed by AJ's character and her servant leadership skills that are in and outside of Bible Song High School. She serves others with a kind and encouraging heart, and that's going to be what sets her apart as she becomes a young professional. She continually does her best to bring out the best in others, and I just wish you so much luck, AJ, as you continue before. I remember when I was first getting to know the students in my fall last year, I had to come up with some strategies to remember names because I've done camp and other things forever, but I'm just horrible with names. So that first week I had to think of, like, how am I going to remember? And for Abby, I remember writing down distinctive laugh. And I remember hearing it throughout class, and I always welcomed it because it was a very infectious laugh, and it always cheered people up. So that's one thing I was really, really grateful for. Abby's among one of the more well-versed students I've ever taught because she is so involved in the community and in school. She's a great amount of school pride and personality that represents the best of MWHS. She's always willing to help with projects in choir, even though it's accompanied with a sarcastic side. Abby has never been shy to share her musical gifts with school and community, and I doubt that will ever change. It's been a pleasure to witness Abby treating everyone like a friend throughout the school day. She understands how important it is to expose yourself to things that can happen and to not shy away from them at all. I sense Abby is going to be a very respected leader in the future, and I want to wish her the absolute best. So thanks for your time. So it's been really fun to teach Max because he brings so much curiosity to the subject of music. That's all I have to say. A day doesn't go by when Max is raising his hand and asking why or how do we approach this, this nice thing we're working on. I remember being so confused when I learned that last year was his first year in choir. Because I remember thinking, how can this guy have such a refined and powerful baritone voice without basically any training before he might have it? As I got to know more, it wasn't as surprising anymore because I learned that if Max is fixated on what he's interested in, he can really take on anything. His curiosity fuels him and is able to recognize when he's made a mistake. He's a naturally gifted musician, and all it took was more exposure to vocal music for him to really take off. I have a fond memory of people asking, what recording did you use in the musical we use at Bochamp before? He played the plan, which is this really like gospel singing low voice. And I was like, oh, what teacher did you get to sing that? That was one of my students. And so I think that's a testament to how much he's grown even in that one year. I said that Max has realized his gift, that is, it's a very rare gift, I would say. And he has been conscious about nurturing it with the same curiosity that brought him into it. So I hope he remembers that curiosity is the thing that really continues to get as you continue to study course. I mean, if you do, I believe that you will see a lot of success. And I just thank you for everything you've done this week. So, during auditions, I remember last year for Country Choir and Natchez, we didn't have a whole lot of dinners audition. I remember that very specifically. And I remember being a bit worried and thinking, oh, please God, can we just have one more dinner boy somehow drop out of them into audition? And I remember literally that next day I got an email from this guy, and he was like, hey, I'm interested in audition choir. And I remember him walking in, and he said, well, you know, I sang baritone in the past, but I kind of want to get back in the choir and sing it. And I did one vocalization, and I said, go, you're a tenor. That's an absolute voice. So, I remember thinking, a little freaked out that my prayers were answered so gloriously quick with this wonderful musician just kind of dropped out of nowhere in my eyes. But Henry's been absolutely wonderful this year. He has a spirit of willingness that is so open to trying new things out of his comfort zone. For example, as soon as he auditioned, he was like, oh, should I audition for Angeles? Oh, should we do a musical? Oh, should we play this friend on this song? And he's just always takes it with grace. And I think that's a huge testament to the person you are and the person you're going to be. Again, like I said, he was immediately recruited for the musical and did an amazing job at school. He takes a special spirit, to be that open and to be able to try so many new things. He's passionate about how music speaks to him. He's always wanting to share it with more. I hope you keep that willingness to share as you discover what's next for you, that's going to be something that is a treasure. So keep sharing what you love. Okay, we'll see you. So Nate is one of the first students I ever met at NWHS last year. I got to know him last fall. I got to know when he played one of my favorite characters of all time. This was Seymour in Ace of Swords. And he had hilarious mannerisms and this subtle humor that was so uniquely made. Through that musical, Pirates of Penzance, this year, Pirates of Choir and Natchez, I got to witness Nate's musical passion and leadership on display. Nate's leadership style is humble and subtle. I witness a lot of behind-the-scenes work that he does to make his peers experience that much better. He is a thoughtful, caring, and empathetic young man who has worked very hard at his craft. His hard work certainly pays off. Musically, I think Nate has one of the better ears and memory that I've come across. Wanting to leave a meaningful impact, Nate has given his time, skills, and passion to the NWHS Choir program. Even singing in the young 8th and 9th grade men's chorus this year so they can have a musical peer with them. And he's there to be an encouraging, helpful guide as they develop their voice as well. It's just a huge testimony to the spirit you have and what you're going to use with it. So thanks for all you do, and I can't see you. Can't wait to see you as well.
All right, jazz band seniors, come on up real quick. Might not have much more, but. So mainly I just wanted to add to what I said earlier is that I do expect you guys to do very well in the future. That's something that is no doubt in my mind that you will. So please keep in touch, let me know how things are going, and please kind of spread the word that now is a good place to grow up. So good luck in the future, and it's really been a pleasure, and I wish you all the best. Thanks, guys.
Spirits, and we're going to leave you with a song called Chili Carne, which they're very fortunate to perform at Soul Hospital this year. Congrats to Ben as well, the work that they were awarded on us inside of this competition. This is one of the clearest on the sciences. You have a wonderful evening. Thank you for being here and
teaching. Cool. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We just decided that one person talks to talk to me, so I got to be good. But I can't say enough about Mr. Paulson. Like, just as he said, he was my first choir teacher, basically one of the only few that I ever had. He helped me grow like my love for his choir music. He's one of the few people that helped me decide to go into vocal performance. And he's, you know, he's just always been nice, been that smiling guy. He come in the seventh hour, he's just chilling there at the piano, smiling, ready to go to class. And somehow it's always encouraging, but if there's one person there to always just be there and help you out. You just sing with him. So many people have been just blessed by being your presence here at Almost Out Bed. I know from all the seniors, we cannot, like, we don't even know what you're going to do because you're just going to rock it in New York. And like, we can't even imagine where you're going to go because you're such an amazing talent as a teacher. We just can't do it for that. But there you go.
Chili con carne, chili con carne, chili con carne.